Hi there, I'm actor Jim Meskimen, and although I usually do impressions on my channel, and that's a lot of fun to do, these days I thought I would read from The Way to Happiness, which is a common sense guide to better living, and it is something I use and have used for decades now when I felt like I needed some happiness or wanted to help other people with happiness. Happiness can be in short supply, but you can always manufacture your own, and this is the way that I do it. This is the third of 21 precepts that are contained in this book. And the reason I'm reading it to you is your survival is important to me. But I'll read the third one right now, which is called, Don't Be Promiscuous. Promiscuous means indulging in casual, random sexual relations. Sex is the means by which the race projects itself into the future through children and the family. A lot of pleasure and happiness can come from sex. Nature intended it that way so that the race would go on. But misused or abused, it carries with it heavy penalties and punishments. Nature seems to have intended it that way also. Number one, be faithful to your sexual partner. Unfaithfulness on the part of a sexual partner can heavily reduce one's survival. History and the newspapers carry floods of instances of the violence of human passions aroused by unfaithfulness. Guilt is the milder evil. Jealousy and vengeance are the greater monsters. One never knows when they will cease to sleep. It is all very well to speak of, quote, being civilized and, quote, uninhibited and understanding. No talk will mend ruined lives. A, quote, feeling of guilt is nowhere near as sharp as a knife in the back or ground glass in the soup. Additionally, there is the question of health. If you do not insist upon faithfulness from a sexual partner, you lay yourself open to disease. For a very brief period, it was said that sexual diseases were all under control. This is not now the case, if it ever was. Incurable strains of such diseases now exist. The problems of sexual misbehavior are not new. The powerful religion of Buddhism in India vanished from there in the 7th century. According to its own historians, the cause was sexual promiscuity in its monasteries. More modernly, when sexual promiscuity becomes prevalent in an organization, commercial or otherwise, the organization can be seen to fail. No matter how civilized their discussions about it, families shatter in the face of unfaithfulness. The urge of the moment can become the sorrow of a lifetime. Impress those around you with that and safeguard your own health and pleasure. Sex is a big step on the way to happiness and joy. There's nothing wrong with it if it is followed with faithfulness and decency. Well, there you go. Just another tip, very important tip from The Way to Happiness. And I'll be back with the rest of these precepts. As I said below, you can obtain your own free copy or print one out for free from the website that's linked below. So I hope it helps, and stay happy and be well.